Let's look at the seventh major shift, which focuses on how application architecture has evolved. Let me give you a quick overview. We have two key frameworks to discuss. First, microservices, or MSA. And second, TOGAF. Both are well-established architectural paradigms. Finally, we'll look at the concept of integration through a reference model for integrated architecture. Integration architecture reference model, known as the integration model. Reference model, abbreviated as IRM. Here's a simple example. SV governance, supporting IT and architectural governance. IT and architectural governance. This system, microservices are essentially a variant of SV. Microservice architecture is also possible. Microservices follows a distinct architectural style. This is the reference model for microservices governance. Here we have a framework diagram. It encompasses numerous underlying concepts. We won't delve into these details today. In the 10th edition of the documentation, you'll need to study microservices. Learn about this concept. Study SV and service governance. Now, let's look at it. This represents a monolithic system. The traditional monolithic architecture. Here we have a microservice architecture. Next step is microservice identification. When you ask about heritage, which doesn't make much sense, you can apply DDT for service identification. That's one approach. However, TOGAF10 isn't particularly compatible with this approach. I probably shouldn't mention this, but TOGAF10 has some resistance to this method. Nevertheless, the approach remains valuable. That's my perspective on it. Use it if you find it helpful. However, in TOGAF10, there's no mention of this even up to version 10. Though in its Agile guidelines, TOGAF10 does address this concept. So I'd say it takes a neutral stance.